Hey guys, Rob here, and welcome back to my Let's Play for the Extermination Day beta. This time we're going to continue on in the Secret Duke Nukem level. And like I mentioned in the previous video, there is a completely new Duke Nukem level in this in the starter pack right now. So I really hope that the secret exits for this map will lead to that level, because well, that level looked absolutely fantastic, so I really want to include that one in this let's play. But again, if I don't happen to find the right exit for it, or maybe the exit doesn't even exist yet, I really don't know, then I will do a separate video on it and just skip to that map with the console command. So anyway, no matter what happens, you guys are going to see that map, so don't worry about that. Yeah, I apologize if if my voice was a little too quiet in the previous video. I am really just struggling with those OBS settings. I mean, sometimes they're kind of okay, other times they're just complete crap. So after this let's play, I'm going to take a little bit of time to do research for the ideal settings, because even when my voice is kind of the right volume, I still have a lot of distortion and stuff, and I have a pretty good headset, so that's the headset isn't really the problem, I think. It's just that for some reason the microphone is always way too quiet, so I have to constantly turn it up to, like, I mean, now I turned it back to 500%, but that just can't be right. But if I put it on 100%, you can't even hear my voice when the game audio is there. And the game audio is turned all the way back to 40%, and then the desktop audio is also turned way back to 40%. So I really turned that down, and for some reason it's still very loud. Yeah, I like the idea here that we actually see the Doom movie, and you know what I like even more? That we can shoot that movie, because, well, I thought it was an entertaining movie, but it really didn't have anything to do with Doom, man. I mean, one of the maps for the Project Brutality campaign has a lot of... You can just see that it had a lot of inspiration from the movie Event Horizon. And the funny thing about Event Horizon is that that movie's story has much more to do with Doom than the actual Doom movie. So yeah. By the way, the map I'm talking about, I might be able to show that map for you guys later on. But that, I can't promise that yet. The developer is hard at work on it, and again, we can't just show every map that we are making, because we don't want to spoil the entire campaign before it even releases. So I am probably be able to do that map anyway, because it's gonna be the first map from the for the campaign. So it would make sense that if I did show some kind of demo, that it would make sense for it to be the first map. So, but again, I can't promise you anything. That's really up to the developer. And for some maps, even if the developer insists for me to play, if it just doesn't feel right, that I feel I'd spoil too much, I probably won't do it anyway. Or maybe I can just show off some parts of certain maps. That's really, I just keep communicating with that developer to do the right thing, because we also want to have a large audience when it comes out. I mean, we want to hype it up a little bit, because, well, the guys did so much incredible work and spent so much time on it. It would suck if like only 20 people get to play it at first. So they really try to use my channel to gather a large audience, and so far that's working out great for them, and for me of course, because those videos usually get more views, because, well, it's exclusive beta stuff. So it's a win-win situation, but we really need to be careful not to spoil too much in that process. So yeah, we just keep communicating about that stuff, and do the right thing to get a large audience, but also just leave a lot of nice surprises for you guys. I mean, if you know everything what's happened already, then you can still enjoy it, but it's just not the same if you just really just see something like that by complete surprise. Die, bitch! Yeah, that's great. Yeah, the secret Duke Nukem. Oh wait, the secret exit is over here. Used to be over there. No, it's not. Or maybe I missed it. Oh boy. I really hope I don't mess this up, man. Yeah. You see, the secret Duke Nukem the secret exit for this level used to be oh god damn, I just jump off again. Used to be through that window there. But now it's gone. That worries me a little, because, well, not only can I is it possible that I don't find the secret exit now, but it's also possible that I might not even be able to play the Wolfenstein maps now, and that would suck. Yeah, that's the downside of a blind Let's Play. You can just show anything, but yeah, that leaves also a few surprises for you guys, I guess. And like I said, no matter what, I am going to play that new map. So you're going to see it anyway. But oh, wait, what's here? I really hate this jump, by the way. It's another one of those awful jumps in this. But at least that one is just for a secret and not, you know, the where you actually have to supposed to go to progress. So it's not that bad. Yeah, now I'm just wandering around this map here too, because I really want to find that secret exit, man. It's not behind this mirror. I really like the new movie posters, by the way, but I really hope the map is not go- of the mod is not gonna be in trouble because of some copyright bullshit. Not sure if you just can, if you can just use that. This sucks, man. Hold on, I'm gonna save because I don't wanna climb all of that again. You know, I just have to see this. I'm sorry, man, but I really don't think I have a choice now. Is it still here? Yes, it is. So why can't I? Why is it that I cannot jump in here anymore? Don't tell me I have to rocket jump, because we saw already that that doesn't work. You see? I don't know why, but the rocket jumping is completely broken now. Maybe if I do this, I mean jump and do this. Oh yeah, what's going on here, man? Is there supposed to be a barrel or something? What is this? This is bothering me, man. You know, I guess I can get a barrel if there's some, if there is even one still not blown up. This sucks, man. You know, I did beat the map anyway. I'm missing two secrets though, so there is really something I haven't seen yet. But what could it be? Maybe the secret exit is completely different now. Still can't destroy that mirror. Come on. This is shit. Yeah, this is one of you know, there is no secret that I missed, because I know of this one. And the other secret is, well, that room I just saw you with no clip. I made it, but it still fell off. Oh god, you know what, fuck this. You get the idea. But yeah, I really don't know what's the problem there. So, you know, if Sergeant Mike intended it to be for a rocket jump there, that means that I can't go to that place now, because the rocket jumping doesn't work. I mean, usually when you just jump and shoot that rocket, you fly up high in the high in the air. But that doesn't happen at all. You can't gain any height anymore. So maybe it has to do something with the new coding for the jumping, because you did also include that mass gravity and stuff. So yeah, if you did intend it for it to be a rocket jump, that means that I have to do this right now. So I apologize. Wait, this doesn't work at all. What? No, seriously, what's going on here? Is it broken? I can't even this way. So wait, no, this. It's done something. That means that I really have to go to the normal action right now. I mean, this is the last secret, but that's clearly not... You're not supposed to go here at all anymore, so... Yeah, I'm sorry then, if I... Yeah, you see, this brings you to the new Duke Nukem level, so... Sergeant Mike, you still need to remove that the old secret then. Alright, now we're gonna have some fun. Because this map, I saw a video of it and it was absolutely incredible, so... He didn't totally recreate that map of Duke Nukem. Because he also said that there had to be some differences to keep it interesting, you know? So that makes a lot of sense. Die, you fucking bastard! Yeah, did you like having a hat? Well, you don't have one anymore, you motherfucker. Okay, so... Weird. Oh my god! Oh, no. That's awful, man. I can't show that on my channel. The worst thing is about it is that I know where it's from. Can I shoot it? No, I cannot. Oh god. I really hope that my video doesn't get censored for that. Yeah, but if you don't know where that's from, there is a little mod called H-Doom, which you don't want to see, trust me, you don't want to see that mod. But it's pretty much a pornographic mod for Doom, so... And you know, in Duke Nukem there was all kinds of porn and strippers in the map, so that's why he did it, and he still did it kind of Doom related, but it's just fucked up, man. So, oh god. I like the idea though that they used H-Doom for that instead of using the Duke Nukem textures, but you know that stuff like that is strictly forbidden on YouTube, and for a good reason. So I really hope this doesn't affect my channel in any way. But if so, that wouldn't be fair. I mean, I didn't do that intentionally. And I looked that way as much as I could. So I'm sure it's fine. Oh wait, we have a... Oh yeah. That's what we want to see. But on the other hand, it's kind of weird when you think about it that, like, people doing their business is a thing that's just not acceptable anywhere. But people being ripped to shreds and turned into piles of gore and blood, that's perfectly fine. That's really weird when you think about that. I mean, you can see like the bloodiest horror movie and it's only for 16 years and older, or at least in my country. But people having sex? Nope. You have to be 18 for that. Well... That red fog and light looks really great when you're in here, but from a distance it looks very weird. I also really like the sky here. This is a great map. I believe you actually have to explode the entire building in this map, and I can't wait to see that. Wait, speaking of it, yeah, here it is. Oh yeah!
Go fuck yourself!
That's amazing. That's... Yeah. Well, now we pick up the red key. Is this a secret or where I'm supposed to go? It's just an alternative way. Alright. Oh, I have to be careful now. I'm at 72 health. We have a bar. And bullets. Why is this symbol here? Can't do anything with it. Can I use those phones? No, I can't also cannot destroy them. Alright, ooh, tonight, hot, hot, hot. That is so Duke Nukem. Oh yeah, I remember this. Oh shit! I didn't remember that trap. Ouch. Yeah, there you go. That was a very risky move there. You hear that music? Ah, I'm not invited to this party. So I need to find that key. Alright. Ooh, looks nice. Ah, we can destroy that screen. Can I destroy the jukebox? Or even better, can I use that jukebox? I have to know. Nah, you can't use it. That's a missed opportunity right there, Sergeant Mark. That would be cool if you actually could use that, and that's some kind of cool party music is starting to play. But well, there is cool party music in this anyway. Because now I am invited to the party. Yeah, in Duke Nukem there is there is a stripper right here, but now it's Baron of Hell, which isn't really that sexy, but you know, I guess they have their rights too. If they want to be strippers, good for them, right? Everything's better than, well, being a demon. I like this music, by the way. I haven't played actual Duke Nukem, so I don't know if it's what music there is in Duke Nukem itself. The reason that I do know that it's not the same as the original Duke Nukem is because I saw that in the comment section for the video where Sergeant Mark showed this map off. Yeah, I really need to play Duke Nukem at some point. I mean, I like classic shooters. So you can't go wrong with Duke Nukem then. Alright, so where do I need to go now? Because I press this switch. Oh wait, that's open now. Okay. Oh, the party is over. Oh shit. Yeah, what's with that fatality? That's just... I'm sorry, but... I always thought that fatality was a little bit dumb. Oh well. So that's the exit. Final destination. Alright, so... This is also a very cool map. It's not a big surprise in a shooter to see a train station map, but... It's nice to see it in Doom for once. Oh, it's not really the first time that that's been done, but... It's always a nice addition. I mean... I like those kind of maps. This map is a little bit... It's actually pretty hard, because... There isn't much health around, and... This is really an endurance. And in that train there are gecko demons on the outside. It is a total bitch move. Because most of the time you can't reach them because they are flying over the train. And then you're trying to dodge enemy projectiles and then they just... They like take you from outside the window. It is... Both terrifying, but also... It's also kinda cool, but it's really... It's tough. And I don't start out with much health anyway. You know, it looks like I just missed the Wolfenstein level. I think that there is a secret exit somewhere in that new Duke Poker map that I missed. At least I imagine that's what it is. So I apologize. Ah, shit, you motherfucker! I apologize if I missed that, but I really don't feel like going all the way back to still do that map, because I played it before like 2 or 3 times already on my channel. So. And I don't really think there are much changes there. Maybe I am wrong, but... Yeah, I am not going to do that that map in this Let's Play. The most important thing for me was that new Duke Nukem level. And you saw that run right now, so... Mission accomplished, I think. And when that releases, I'm going to do a lot of practice. And then you are going to see an actual walkthrough instead of a let's play. Yeah, I really have to focus in this map. And if it's not gonna work, I'm just going to save. Because like I explained before, I like to do the maps legit, but I also want to keep this Let's Play entertainment, so... If I have to save, I will. I'm not gonna make you watch this map like 20 times or something. I shouldn't say it, but it's going a lot better now. You know what? Screw it. I'm gonna save. Yeah, and this map is even worse in Project Brutality, because you have those infernal gecko demons that, and those spawn watchers. You don't spawn them that often, but if you don't, if If you just can't take them out and they see you, that means they're gonna they occasionally spawn a watcher outside, and that's like having another small gecko demon here. You see, and they constantly take you from the side, and that's just mean. And now I can't reach him because he's probably above the other. Oh, he is. Right. Oh, there is another one. I hope I got them all now. Not sure how many there are. Okay. So far, so good. You know what? I'm sorry, man. Careful, maybe there's still geckos outside. We have the blue key, and finally every time when you see a medkit in this map, you just it's such a relief. I mean, there is pretty much isn't anything like that in this map at all, except for the ant. There are some stim packs, I believe, and the medkit. But that's it. And I started this map with like 30 health or something. That gecko is still alive. And that's gonna bite me in the ass, quite literally. But I can't do much about it right now, so I have to go on. Yeah! Boom. Yeah, and now the train stops. Not sure if those train sounds are new. I don't think they are, but they might, so. Right. Oh god. Oh! Goddamn Revenant rockets. You know, I like to know if this is still in the new version. No, it doesn't hurt you from close up. That's good, because I really didn't like that. Project Fatality still does that, I believe. Or maybe I didn't notice that they changed because, well, because of that, I am of course never try that again, so. Yeah, the plasma gun should be a relative safe weapon to use. Oh man, I really hate Revenants. They're the coolest enemies out there, but their homing missiles are just. They can fuck you so bad. And again, there was a stem pack here, but that's really it. So every single hit counts here. Ah, and every single mistake is piling up. Luckily, you have those. Brutal. This part I really hate. Because you can't really move to that debris properly. So you always end up stuck. And you have to dodge projectiles and stuff. It's really unpredictable unless you know exactly where it blocks you and where it doesn't. So just like that. Don't you think I should hit him right there? But no, that's not happening. Oh man, thank god I saved. Come on, yeah, this is just awful again. You should either remove this some of this debris or just make you be able to walk through it, because this is not fun. This really feels random and unfair. Because you can't even jump over most of them. So you really end up just stuck when you're trying to dodge projectiles and shoot those fucking assholes. You see, I can't even hit him. And I'm right in front of him right now. Yeah, fuck you, him. I'm gonna save again. I'm sorry, man, that I'm doing this right now, but... I don't even really have that much time anymore for this, so I really don't want to redo too much. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh, ow. Thank god, I thought I would be stuck there for a moment, but thankfully I could just walk away there. Oh, shit. Yeah, I'm gonna try it from here without saving though. The worst thing about this part is, again, the Lost Souls, man. Yeah, I haven't really used the grenade launcher much. But that's not a very useful weapon here. Like, the only reason I would use it is, well, to show you guys what it does. But that's really the only reason. Yeah, there we go. There is a medkit. I believe there is another medkit around here. No, there's not. In these plants. Oh, at least I can get some health from here. Okay. Oh, how did I not notice that one? Good god, man. Alright. This part is challenging. Always just run. Use some explosives to blow them all up. Yeah, as you might see, I'm getting a lot more used to this talking and playing at the same time stuff. My gameplay is still not as good, of course, as the videos where I don't have to talk, but it's getting better and better. Alright, there's some imps here. Just like in the old version. Well, and I guess that's it. So, yeah, that's it, and that's it also for the video, so I will thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video where we're going to play the Eye of the Storm, which is a It's a pretty epic map. It's not one of my favorites, but it's pretty good. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.